We need someone to take us to an island located here.
That's the deadliest part of the ocean.
There is no island there.
Ooh, baby, easy peasy.
Let's go.
Oh!
That's my security system.
I'd rather take the Titanic.
Here's the deal. A few nights ago, a radio signal got sent out from these coordinates. It could be the mysterious island that Jules Verne wrote about.
Hey, it's Genevieve Loh, your flick chick from today's newspaper. An outlandish plot, a survivor-esque location, another Jules Verne novel, and visual extravagance are all the ingredients to make it this follow-up to the 2008 hit Journey to the Center of the Earth. Up-and-comer Josh Hutcherson returns as intrepid teenage explorer Sean Anderson, who goes in search of the mysterious island with his stepfather, Dwayne "The Rock" Johnson, in hopes of finding his grandfather, Michael Caine. And of course, Vanessa Hudgens appears along the way to provide the requisite eye candy and love interest.
This is heaven, I'm checking in.
This is amazing.
Well, don't just stand there, Grandpa!
Who's up for an adventure?
What is this place?
So nothing rings true in this fantasy adventure, and the characters and plotline get seemingly more caricatured and one-dimensional. But the barrage of impressive, dazzling special effects and gratuitous use of 3D means it's a rollicking ride anyway. Much like its predecessor, Journey 2 combines 3D, CGI, and live action to create a light-hearted Indiana Jones-style adventure in which its cast isn't afraid to have fun. There's an underlying theme about kids being abandoned by their fathers, which never really gets explored. But hey, substance isn't this film's strong point, and little time or energy is wasted before getting into the action.
If we get torn a bit,
run!
I'm blaming you.
The Rock, taking over the lead role from Brandon Fraser, surprisingly exudes goofball comic timing. Capable of sparring successfully with the ever-charming Michael Caine, he's seen to silly moments like playing the ukulele or fires berries off his flexing pecs. As unnecessary and random as popping pecs are, and you have to see it to believe it, but it's a good example of how this film doesn't take itself too seriously, and neither should we. Three bags of popcorn.
There is no island there.
Baby, easy peasy.